lined up, official ready to drop the puck. The Ducks take possession here on the opening drive. We are underway. Oh, he's up nice. Oh, what a save!
Now, he was locked in on that. The shooter prepares the puck, and the goaltender is right on top of it to make the save.
Lots of time left in this period. The game is still scoreless. Handles the puck. The Ducks pick up steam and are on the attack. Scores! Well, there's no kicking motion review when you kick it into your own net.
Oh, that's a bad bounce there, James. The puck bounces in off the defender's skate. Can't really do much about that.
Anaheim's got the game's first goal, and it didn't take long.
They wanted to attack quickly, and now that they're on the road and they've got the lead, they can dictate the pace.
Shens won the draw inside the neutral zone. There's a collision with some authority. Puck sent over to Terry. Binnington. Scooped up along the wall by Cruz. The Ducks scoop it up along the boards.
Binnington's made what looks like a pretty important save. He got blown out in his last game. That's a nice start for him.
Textbook stop by Gibson. Anaheim's got a hold of it against the wall. On the attack, they come down the right wing. Takes a shot. And not much on that one. Official blows the play dead as the puck goes out of bounds. Still lots of time left in the period. Anaheim's ahead 1-0. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Yeah, the officials didn't like that. The arms are in the air. And let's see what the call is.
Well, this doesn't help a comeback for sure, but you've got to regain your focus and count on your penalty killers, then get back to work.
Comes out for the faceoff.
And so they'll get their first power play of the evening. At the very least, you want to make sure you get pucks to the net, win some puck battles so you retrieve the puck. You just do not want on your first power play to have a poor one, because that can leak into subsequent power plays as the game goes on.
Taken by Parayko. The Ducks gain control of the puck against the wall. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Oh, what a stop by Binnington.
He's sharp on that one. Nowhere to go for the puck.
Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Oh, what a play.
I like it, James. He can't be held up. Once he gets rid of the puck, he gets it on the other side.
Snaps it onto the net. Scores! And there it is, the power play goal.
So determined to get to the front of the net, and once he's in between the hash marks, you know he's thinking, I'm in a scoring spot. That puck comes to him. Next place is in the net.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Henrique's won the draw here in the neutral zone. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. Heads deep inside the offensive zone. St. Louis has it in the defensive end. And now it's grabbed by Cruz. Great reach with the poke check. And he slides it quickly to Cruz. Receives the pass. Turned aside with the glove by Gibson. Anaheim's got it along the wall. Takes it to the net. Scores! And that's three unanswered goals on their part. Wow!
Once you get one, you feel a little bit of momentum come to your team. Now you got a couple and then a third. You feel like you're just going to carry this game and walk away with it. He kept moving in that high slot, looking for an area that might be open. Then the puck's on and off his stick. Nice shot. Past the halfway mark of this period, the Ducks have taken control of this one, now leading by three. The Blues get a hold of the puck off the draw. Here's a short pass to Strome. An easy save by Gibson. Anaheim's looking to break out. Now he takes it over the line. From point blank, buries it for the goal.
I always wanted to have a fast start. It's funny, you go no goals in three games in the middle of the year, nobody cares. At the start, it really matters. From the goalie's perspective, there's so much traffic they can't see. So he just drops into the butterfly, hopes he's in the right position. But that puck sees some air, and it beats him clean.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck to get play back underway. Strome's won the draw. Dumps the puck in. Quick feed to Drysdale.
No, he's only one goal away, James, from his next milestone here.
And that one's denied! And they score! Again! And this fan base has turned here, Razor.
Man, have they ever. And honestly, I mean, they don't want to watch this anymore. The players don't want to play it anymore either. Can this thing go to running time soon?
Teams are ready to go, and we're about moments away from puck drop. Anaheim's won the faceoff, and that doesn't reach the net. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Moves it to Terry. Gives him a jolt with that hit. The Blues get a hold of the puck along the boards. Shoots it on the backhand.
The Ducks continue to be in a comfortable lead here, although this one hits the pipe. You know, the shooter would have loved this to go in.
They go on the attack from the left side. Both teams getting a good sweat on after this first period. We've got lots more in store, and we're coming back with a clean sheet of ice next. With a chance to recharge and refresh, and this second period about set to get underway. A one-sided affair thus far. Let's see if anything changes here with the start of the second. Ray, as we get things underway here in this second period, give us a sense of what you interpreted from that first 20 minutes.
St. Louis wants to get back in this game. They got to have the puck a little more. Their possession time was almost nothing in the first period. They've got to get the puck, hold it, and start grinding their way back into this game.
Great heads-up play in the offensive end. St. Louis looks to break out of their own end. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. They've got numbers. It's a two-on-one. From the slot, and the shot dies in the traffic jam. Through center along the wing. Tremendous hit on the play, and that'll... And here we go.
The crushing blow to finish it.
Sometimes you're just too big or too strong for the guy you line up against, and that one ended like it should have.
If there's a sliver of positivity here, it's the coach would like to see a little more pushback. Well, he got some there.
And the crowd seems to have come alive with this one as well. Well, it looks like the officials have got all the debris off the ice, and we're back to getting some hockey going again. St. Louis will go to work here in the offensive end. Oh, a clutch save! Penalty coming up. Whistle stops the play. The Ducks are going to be penalized for a boarding call here. Man advantage takes to the ice. It's our first opportunity to get a glance at the special teams unit.
Well, here's our first power play of the game. You'd love to score on your first one if you get the chance, because that helps the power play become more confident. More confident always means more successful.
2-on-1, what an opportunity here! Stolarz elects for the breather and goes for the whistle.
I like this play, James. He's seen enough chaos in front of him.
Henriques recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. And a solid stop on the play there. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Across the line, along the left wall. Anaheim's going to play the puck. They score!
They were talking this morning about they had noticed some vulnerabilities on that other power play. They thought they could attack it, and they cash in on the shorthanded goal. Lots of times we talk about the defenseman and the forwards battling for position in front of the net. Well, the goalie's battling for it, too. He's trying to find the puck. When he can't see it, he's going to drop into the butterfly and play the percentages. Hope the puck hits him. Not this time. You'll find this one in the cage.
Puck picked up by Ylevi. With possession along the wall. Stopped by the goaltender. Quick pass to Saad. Puck grabbed by Strome. The Ducks have possession shorthanded. Poked away in the neutral zone. Anaheim's got the puck along the wall. Slides it diagonally to Saad. Moves it over to Henrique. Looking to set up offensively. Anaheim's got the puck behind the net. Henrique's got it along the wing. Puck scooped up by Grant. And that's kicked out from the scrum. Beautiful read in the defensive end by Strome. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end.
Nothing but a discombobulated start to this power play. The crowd is all over them. They want a little more offensive zone time. Actually, they'd like some.
Heads to the back of the net.
Oh, James, that's close. I thought this was in. I thought the forward was going to be able to get to the post first. But he's got it. That's a really strong save.
No room right there.
Stolarz is just one of the team picture tonight. There's not anybody across the board that can look in the mirror and say they've done a good job.
Takes the feed. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Look at this. They've got some bodies here on the attack. Scores! His second of the game.
Now, here's a little math for you, James. One's good, two's better. He finishes off this opportunity, and now it's a great night. They really moved the puck well on the odd man rush, and now they find the exposed player, and that puck is in the back of the net. That's perfectly played.
The Ducks have really opened things up here in the second. It's getting out of hand.
They've run roughshod over their opponent here in this period. It seems like they're going to score every shift.
Vakanainen's got it in the corner. Here's a chance in front. Big save.
I thought they worked the puck around pretty good. Here they get a good chance on goal, but not to be.
Zegras looks around. Solid hit on that play. Nice pass. Sends it deep inside the offensive zone. The Ducks have it now.
The Blues can tell them themselves there's still half a game or so left. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Shen's not going to be able to return to the game. Just got word from the PR department. He's out for the night.
All right, thanks very much for the update, Mr. Ferraro, and we'll see how things are impacted here with the line juggling going forward. Into the corner now. Snaps one on net. Oh, that's a huge stop by Stolarz. Oh, wow, another great stop.
Everybody hesitates for a half a second when they hear the puck hit the goaltender's mask. They all know what that one must feel like. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
And now he moves it to Kerfoot. Kluger's lugging the puck. Uses the force on that hit.
That's another penalty. Three in the period. Their best player was not very happy. He's got to sit here and watch again.
Another power play opportunity coming up here.
You can't doubt yourself on this power play. I mean, I know they gave up the shorthanded goal earlier, James, but you can't start questioning whether you can be an effective power play. Fowler's going to hear it from the crowd for the rest of the night. He caused that earlier injury to the home team player, and they're not very happy with it.
Along the half wall with the puck. St. Louis has it in their own zone. And he gets sandwiched into the wall.
That's really well played by the defensive player. He took away the angle, forced him into a spot, and then laid the hit.
The Blues have it against the wall. Oh, you'll win respect for your teammates doing that. What a block. St. Louis has the puck. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. Here's a shot for the boards. Denies the shooter on that play. Yo Levy's got the puck in his own zone. Moves it around along the half wall. And the save. He got all that hit. Oh, they probably want a redo on that. Anaheim's got the puck along the boards. The Ducks have it from the corner. Approaching the final 60 seconds here in the second. Oh, and that's poked away in the offensive zone by Silverberg. Here we go. It's a 2-on-1. Can't make the connection on the pass. Answered the call there.
Obviously not a more dangerous place on the ice to shoot the puck from dead center. Shooter tries to go under the bar, and the goalie is better with the glove.
Rocked on the play.
Did he ever get it, James? That's a really good hit. Now the player's got to go pick up his stick because that got knocked right out of his hands.
And that concludes the second period of play. Still one more period of regulation time. We'll see what happens in the third next. Welcome back. James Salsky ready to bring you all the play-by-play. Still a full period here. Last chance to try to get back into it in what has been a dominant affair so far. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point so far. Ray, how do you see things?
Anaheim's in a nice spot here. I mean, it's a comfortable lead. They'll be able to play four lines in 6D and not tax anybody too much as they coast in here with a W.
Has the puck, and he'll wait for the faceoff.
I think that's a pretty heady play. There's been a little bit of scramble around him, and he jumps on it. They can get reorganized.
Moments away from the faceoff. Let's get back to the action. The Ducks win the faceoff. Hammers one, and that goes off a player. Big save by the goaltender watching that one. Oh, spectacular save on the play.
Really sharp, never loses sight of the puck to make the second save.
Poked away in the neutral zone by Drysdale. Moves it quickly over to Terry. The Ducks move it ahead. drives it to the crease. Decides to think about it. Oh, what a stop by Stolarz. There's another stop.
The most fun save for the goaltender, the glove stop.
And puts the body into it, a little bumper car hockey. The Ducks move the puck to the defensive zone. Here we go, 2-on-1. Oh, he gets the paddle on it. What a stop by Stolarz.
The shooter's putting the guts of the ice, but the goalie squares up, spreads out, and makes the save.
Answered the call on that play.
Fowler's going to have to dig into the energy tank a little bit here. You lose a lot of energy in a fight, and even though he had 5 minutes to sit down and relax, you never really get back to feeling great.
St. Louis plays the puck along the boards. The Ducks gain possession along the wall. Couldn't complete the play. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Offside the call, we'll get a reset. Ray, maybe you can get a better look down at ringside, but it looks like it'll be equal balance going to the sin bin here.
Oftentimes when there's a mess like this, the officials will hand one penalty out to each side, try and settle everything down.
Puck set to drop. We've got some 4-on-4 coming up.
Once you get the puck on 4-on-4, just don't give it up. You've got space. Use it.
Broussard's gained possession inside the neutral zone. Anaheim's got a hold of it along the wall. Into the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Silverberg. And he had the answer on that play. There it is! He scores! All over the rebound, and he taps it in!
Always follow that puck to the net. Even when you shoot it from that down low spot, keep going to the net. The puck is there. If the goalie stops it, he gets there first, and now he's got a tally on the board.
Anaheim's having a lot of fun out there tonight, but Ray, I can imagine it's a different story on the other side of the bench.
Yeah, half the guys out here are having fun. The other half, this game can't end quick enough.
Slick feed. The Ducks take it along the wall. Shot! Skate save!
Sometimes you're in close, there's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all.
Poked away by Vakanainen. And they continue to fight for that puck along the wall. Can't find his man.
The Ducks have really played their systems well tonight. They've layered defensively, not giving their opponents many chances at all.
Here's an odd man rush. It's a 2-on-1. And he turned that aside as we continue going here. Oh, some strong physicality on the play. Gains the zone through center. Quick feed to McTavish. Nice save by the goaltender to get a pad on that. Grabbed along the board by Vakanainen. And a strong effort on that play.
He's been really good on these high danger chances. And here's another one right from the slot. But he's trapped that puck to keep it in front of him and make the save.
Moves it to McTavish. Blocked in traffic. Poked away at center by Vakanainen. Anaheim's got control of it now from their own end. Gaining momentum along the wing. Solid hit on the play. Tries to get it to Kerfoot. Thunderous hit. Oh, my.
Now that one hurt me over here. That is an enormous hit. He closed the gap in a hurry.
And the intensity started to ramp up here after that hit. And he scores.
Working on getting rid of the puck quicker and quicker and quicker. I mean, it can't come off the stick any quicker than this, and the goalie just can't keep up from this close range.
The Ducks are on absolute cruise control here in the third.
Well, they built such a large margin, you can use your whole bench and coast it in.
Quick pass to Bluger. The Blues take it across the blue line. Looking to make something happen along the boards. The Ducks will play the puck from behind the net. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Comes up with a monster save in front.
Dead center, excellent save.
The Blues get a hold of the puck in their own end. position. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. The Blues move it in. Anaheim's gained possession along the boards. Sends it in front. Breaks it off the post. Passes on over to Thomas. And he slides it quickly to Bluger. Dished on over to Strom. And that's broken up in the defensive zone by Zegras. Streaking into the attacking zone for the right. And that's knocked away by Pontois.